Looking out to ash and dust, I wipe my brow and I sweat my wraps. I'm breathing in the chemicals. I'm breaking in, shaping up and checking out on the prison bars. This is it, the apocalypse.
I'm leaping.
I feel it in my bones, enough to make my systems roll. Welcome to the new age, to the new age. Welcome to the new age. Radioactive, radioactive. Radioactive, radioactive. Darn my clothes, it's a revolution, I suppose. We're painted red to fit right in. Whoa. I'm breaking in, shaping up, and checking out on the prison bars. This is it, the apocalypse. Whoa. I feel it in my bones, enough to make my systems flow. Welcome to the new age, to the new age. Welcome to the new age, to the new age.
Try to speak French. Bonjour. Je suis fatigué.
It's going to be so hard to follow.
Oh, yeah.
je suis très vite.
What did I say?
You just said, I am really, no. Belle ou bête?
Bête.
Bête as stupid. So that's
Taylor. When they ask me later who I would bring back to life, I'm gonna say you, so I can kill you.
I would love us.
Here's Nadia.
Hi guys. So Sachin just told me in a quiet moment that he prepared a dance for you. Jared says he's beatboxing, right? You're doing the beatbox?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, the guys are doing the beatbox and Sachin.
It's your turn. You waited for this moment so long. So.
Vous savez que Sachin a fallu de
d'être
le ici à maintenant.
Pardonne-moi. Bonjour. Ça va? Je ne baille pas. Pardonne-moi. Donc, je me lance. Je m'appelle Ian, Lord of the Dance.
Oh!
On va pas s'ennuyer, je pense.
You're welcome, Chris. I had no idea the paddles in here. I was expecting a tiny room with a handful.
En fait, la pièce pour les balais, je m'attendais pas du tout à ce que ce soit celle-là. Dis-moi, je m'attendais à une toute petite pièce tranquille et j'arrive, vous êtes tous là, ça.
I totally forgot that you have to translate everything. I forgot that everything.
No, you can. You can say long answer.
Yeah, I mean the longest story is possible.
Elle va vous faire les histoires les plus longues.
I have a question for you. When I sit like this, does it look like I have no pants on?
Yes!
You're welcome.
Elle dit quand je suis assise comme ça, on s'appelle la question que j'ai pas de pantalon, c'est ça?
I can only picture all the group photos, I just look like I have no pants.
Mais sur la photo de groupe, c'est vraiment, j'ai l'impression de pas avoir de pantalon, ça, c'est sympa. Vas-y.
You have so many fans all around the world, and that you're a model for
some of them. We have so many fans, or more for some of them. N'hésite pas aussi à nous en français, comme ça tout le monde.
J'aimerais savoir en fait ce que ça leur fait de savoir qu'ils ont beaucoup de fans dans le monde entier et que bah, c'est un modèle pour certains.
Pardon my French, but I'm pretty fucking speechless about it. Yeah, it's cool. I don't really have words for it. It's pretty neat to choose a career that's pretty difficult. And a career that is really, it's a place of vulnerability. So not only are we playing characters, but we're really putting our own heart out there in our art, and to have people receive that in a positive light, it's beautiful.
Et dit, très sincèrement, j'ai pas de mots, ça me laisse un peu sans voix. C'est quand même, on est dans un métier, on a fait une carrière qui est difficile, qui nous rend vulnérable, parce que c'est pas seulement interpréter des personnages, mais on y met aussi tout notre cœur. Et de savoir qu'il y a des gens qui nous aiment et qui nous suivent, bah, ça fait du bien, c'est beau et ça fait plaisir.
Yeah, because it all, yeah, she's walking away.
Oh, wow.
It's okay. No, just to answer your question. Yeah, because on social media, we only see it on Twitter, and it can say that you have hundreds of thousands or millions of followers, but until you see them all in person, it's insane. So, like, the fact that we're in a full room in Paris, France
right
now is nuts. So that can never happen.
Chris disait que c'est une chose de voir sur les réseaux sociaux, par exemple, qu'on va avoir 100 000 ou 1 million ou je sais pas combien de millions de fans qui nous suivent, et c'est vraiment autre chose. Par contre, de se retrouver ici à Paris dans une salle pleine et de le voir en vrai, c'est impressionnant.
Okay. I got it. It's so good to see you back in here.
Yeah. Well, I had a question about the Marlboro scene. Which one was the hardest to film? Like, okay. Quelle était la scène ma peur dure à tourner?
Really trying.
Et j'essaye vraiment de me retenir de ne pas faire une blague inappropriée sur la scène la plus dure.
That scene was hard. That scene was hard. Because it was on day one of season four when when Raven stumbles in on Monty and Harper the second time. It was the first day of shooting for season four. So we were both very nervous. And yeah, it was very hard. The hardest scene was in season four, when Harper refuses to leave.
Totally.
And she's like prone on the bed, crying, and Monty cannot get her to leave. Chelsea makes every scene a lot easier than it should be, because we work really well together, but that was like the most difficult day, I think, that I had.
Le tournage de la saison 4 où il y a la scène entre Harper et Monty où il y a Raven qui débarque comme ça d'un seul coup, c'est la scène la plus dure. Et après il rejoint Bob sur le fait que c'est vraiment une famille et quand ça ils sont extrêmement chanceux. Il dit en plus c'est même pas comme si c'est plus grand soi, on continue à être ensemble, on se parle absolument tous les jours. Il dit et c'est un lien qui est très fort, il dit après effectivement par rapport aux fans, c'est super de voir que notre travail et ce qu'on fait va aider certains ou va emmener les gens sur une certaine voie. Et c'est quelque chose de vraiment très très flatteur. Lui, il a grandi en étant plutôt timide et sans vouloir trop se mêler à l'affectif, etc. Et donc c'est inattendu comme expérience, mais très flatteur.
Richard would like to point out that he's upset that he thinks Daniel might be paraphrasing the thing he says, and he would like Daniel to say word for word.
I speak with a certain eloquence, and I don't appreciate it for paraphrasing my comments.
As the master of ceremonies, I agree. Daniel?
For me, word for word.
Word for word.
Mot pour mot.
No, amazing. Amazing.
I try to words for you guys to know where. Où on dit donc Richard veut que je traduise mot pour mot. Et Sachin dit comme second maître de cérémonie, j'acquiesce.
Juste avant, alors du coup, moi je vais demander les photoshoots GH, s'il vous plaît. Je vais avoir besoin des photoshoots Nadia, Paige, Chris et Chelsea, le groupe GH. I'm gonna need
no, the... no, you don't get up. You have to stay.
I'm gonna need the group GH for the photoshoot with Nadia, Paige, Chris and Chelsea, the group GH.
So we can see where your priorities lie.
Nadia, Chris, and Chelsea. What have they done for you?
I'm not going to fight over those guys.
That's pretty good. That's pretty good.
What, Chris and Chelsea? Marper?
Oh, funny.
Funny guy.
Silence dans la salle, s'il vous plaît. Thank you. Vas-y.
Hi. Ma question c'était pour savoir si vous pourriez définir votre personnage en un seul mot, ce serait lequel?
If you could define your characters in one word, what would be the word?
I've said this before, and I'll say it again, I think it would be relentless. Word for word.
Oui, je l'entends en anglais, impossible de le trouver en français.
Relentless.
Ah!
He didn't say ah!
I got it in English, the word relentless.
But for that?
We do, I just have to...
Relentless.
C'est sans... C'est ah!
This is actually fun, I'm just gonna stump you for the rest of the day. I'm trying so hard.
Oh no, Google is my best friend.
Mime le.
Word for word.
No, sans
scrupule,
non?
Sans scrupule.
Sans scrupule.
Sans scrupule.
Sans scrupule.
Vous avez deux mots. On a un mot. On a un seul mot. Sans
sinon, ça va?
Dernier appel pour les photographes, Yann et Jarod, s'il vous plaît. Dernier appel. Last call for the autograph with Jarod and Ian, please.
No! Wait!
Merci.
Julien Arnaud.
Impitoyable.
Julien.
On peut applaudir, s'il vous plaît.
I would say evolving. Ever changing.
Evolve.
Qui évolue. Évoluant.
Ouais, bah,
évolutif. Évoluer. Qui continue à aller de l'avant, quoi.
Mine is happy.
Abby.
Because I say Abby a lot. I say Abby.
Tout le temps, Abby.
Okay, so what do you think Bellamy would change about Murphy? And what do you think Murphy would change about Bellamy? If they could change one thing about each other?
That's a good question.
Qu'est-ce que chacun changerait chez l'autre par rapport au personnage?
I think Bellamy would want Murphy to see, you know, to start believing in his own worth and not necessarily, like, I think Murphy does believe in himself, but he doesn't feel like he's involved or part of a group, and I think Bellamy wants him to have that awareness that he is actually part of a group, and he wants him to become who he believes him to be. I think Bellamy actually tries to see the best in people. He hated Murphy for a long time there, but there's a part.
Not you.
But there's a part of Murphy that, you know, feels like he's an outsider and holds on to that. And I think that's something that Bellamy's like, you got to drop that act because we're all survivors and trying to survive here. Like, you're just the same as everyone else. You know, bro. I think that's what he wants.
Il pense que ce que Bellamy aimerait, c'est que Murphy arrête de toujours faire entre guillemets le sentir le pire. Il dit parce que même si Murphy il croit en lui et il sait qu'il peut aller au bout des choses et c'est un survivant, il est toujours persuadé qu'il est en dehors du groupe et qu'il ne fait pas partie, qu'il n'est pas du tout dans l'unité au sein des autres. Et Bellamy, il a toujours tendance à essayer de voir le meilleur chez les autres. Et il aimerait que Murphy puisse voir le bien qu'il y a en lui et qu'il peut réellement faire partie du groupe. Si la confiance qu'il a en lui dans ce qu'il fait de mal, il le met dans la notion de bien avec le groupe. Merci.
me in. You could have come with me. Silent screams hurt me. As for my
was beating up Bellamy
because she was so upset over Lincoln's death. And just trying to put the blame on somebody. Have any of you put the blame on somebody over something that you felt pain about? Yeah, me too.
En gros, sa scène la plus difficile à tourner, ça a été la scène où elle démonte Bellamy parce qu'elle était trop triste par rapport à la mort de Lincoln et il fallait absolument qu'elle trouve quelqu'un sur qui rejeter la faute. Et là, elle disait, est-ce que vous, justement, ça vous est jamais arrivé de trouver un bouc émissaire pour rejeter la faute sur quelqu'un d'autre quand vous avez eu mal?
Oui, alors vous n'avez pas de réponse.
So what about you, Jessica?
Okay, so three, like whatever our call time is, so let's say your call time is, like crew call is like noon in a day. 3 hours after crew call, because you get breakfast when you get there, so there's breakfast like the hour before crew call, so let's say breakfast at 11, crew call's noon. 3 hours after we start shooting, you get sandwiches. It's like sandwich time. And it's really difficult when your call time is, let's say, 4 o'clock in the afternoon, and then you miss sandwiches. So then the sandwiches are just kind of shaving the mold that way. Those are the tougher days.
Yeah. Les moments les plus difficiles, il faut savoir que voilà, quand on appelle l'équipe, on va appeler l'équipe à midi pour commencer à tourner, mais genre 3 heures plus tard. Donc en gros, ils viennent à 11h pour avoir un petit déjeuner, enfin un bon petit déjeuner. Après, ils commencent à. Donc à midi, on appelle les gens pour tourner. Du coup, 3 heures plus tard, on a des sandwichs. Après, pour qu'ils aillent. Et à 10, ce qui est chiant, c'est quand on est appelé à 16h, et du coup, on a ni le petit déjeuner, ni les sandwichs. Voilà, on est que les miettes et les trucs.
I'm making you go to that one. Yeah, Marie wants to change her answers to that one. I'm kidding. The difficult stuff. Well, anything outside in Vancouver in the winter is difficult already because of the weather. But the show is very emotional. And when you're filming at like 3 in the morning and it's raining, and then everyone's emotional because there's terrible things happening.
And they get their periods.
And then you get your period and you've got the flu. Those are tough. Tough days, but we all love each other.
Ladies, when you get your period, anything is tough. Right?
Men?
Jessica est en train. Donc, Jessica disait déjà toutes les scènes en extérieur, en hiver, à Vancouver, c'est compliqué. Il pleut, il fait un froid canard. Donc, c'est déjà assez difficile d'aller tourner à 3h du mat. Surtout qu'en plus, voilà, on n'est pas toujours. On est fatigué, ça nous rend beaucoup plus émotif, ce à quoi Marie a rajouté. Et quant à tes règles, elle dit c'est vrai, en plus, quand vous avez les règles, elles tous semblent beaucoup plus difficiles. Donc, n'est-ce pas, mademoiselle?
Oui, voilà.
En attendant de ce petit gant, moi j'en profite juste pour faire une annonce. Donc, pour les autographes de Chelsea, s'il vous plaît, juste ceux d'en bas, levez la main ceux qui ont un autographe de Chelsea qui s'était prévu pour aujourd'hui. Vous pouvez y aller. Ceux de derrière, est-ce que vous pouvez lever la main si vous avez un autographe de Chelsea prévu? Vous pouvez y aller. I need everyone for the autograph of Chelsea that was set for today. You can go do your autograph of Chelsea. The same thing for Paige. Who was supposed to do his autograph with Paige today? You can go. Qui a été prévu à faire ses autographes avec Paige aujourd'hui? Ceux qui ont les autographes qui ont été prévus pour Page et Chelsea, vous pouvez y aller. Les autographes Page et Chelsea.
That's like, I'm trying to just like learn French right now. On stage.
Murray's a multitasker.
Vas-y.
Is anyone trying to learn English? I can help you.
Si quelqu'un essaie d'apprendre l'anglais, il peut vous aider.
I'm trying to learn French.
Parce que là, elle essaie d'apprendre le français. Vas-y.
Bah bonjour Marie et Marie.
Bonjour.
Bah comment ça c'est est-ce que quand tu étais avec Lincoln et qu'il est mort, quand tu es parti te réfugier chez Liliane, je sais pas, et que quand il est mort, tu as pleuré. Est-ce que c'est, tu t'es vraiment réfugié vers lui ou c'était juste, c'était vraiment tu l'aimais vraiment?
Well, technically, so far, I've been here.
Oh no!
Un mot. J'ai
compris le sens de la question.
Elle était avec Lincoln. Il est mort. Après, elle est partie se réfugier chez les Iliades. Et bien, quand il est mort, elle a pleuré. Est-ce qu'elle est vraiment partie se réfugier vers lui ou elle l'aimait vraiment?
Iliades? So,
okay.
You were with Lincoln. Lincoln
yeah.
died.
Yeah.
You were really yeah. sad. You tried, and
oh,
you went to Ilian.
Yeah, my brother.
Yeah. Did you really like it, or was it just like sauce?
Do any of you understand English in the audience?
Yeah.
Thank God. Ever had a rebound before, after love? Raise your hand.
Est-ce que vous avez déjà eu a rebound guy, rebound girl?
Rebound love. Your heart was fucking broken, and then you had a rebound. Raise your hand.
Est-ce qu'on peut baisser le micro vert un tout petit peu, s'il vous plaît? The green.
Okay, that's what Ilian was. So now, do you all understand?
Yes.
Nice. Okay, good. Oh,
they
shut off my microphone.
No, it works. No, it works.
I don't think it works anymore. Oh, it does work. Okay.
Yeah.
Anywho, that explains that, okay?
Good. Now list your rebounds by name. Go. Do you have photographs of these people?
Le rebound guy, pour ceux qui ne savent pas, c'est voilà, vous avez été avec quelqu'un hyper amoureux, ça a duré 3-4 ans. Ouais, c'est le mec pense-non ou la fille pense-non, genre vous ressortez avec quelqu'un un peu derrière, mais finalement vous ne serez jamais amoureux ou amoureuse, c'est juste que.
I couldn't hear you. We're gonna do that at the closing battle again too. That was too much fun.
Breathe.
How does the qu'est-ce que c'est la chanson?
Qu'est-ce que who?
La chanson.
La cochon.
Oh, you remember last year we were starting singing a song about La Famille?
Oh my god, that La Famille song? Oh my god. You remember that?
Hey!
La Famille! Hey! La Famille! I like the Bambi, you like the Bambi, we like the Bambi! Hey! La Famille! That was the most ridiculous. I've done a lot of ridiculous things at this convention. That is by far the most ridiculous thing I've ever done.
Who composed that?
I was sitting here and I said, you know, we should have a La Famille song. And then I just said that and said, that can't be it. But then it got catchy.
Is the only music just you going?
The only music is, I think I was going like. Hey! La Famille. Hey! La Famille. I like the Famille. Like the Famille. We like the Famille. Hey! La Famille.
Like, what stories can you tell them that you haven't told them?
I've told them everything. They know everything about my entire life.
Okay.
There's nothing you don't know now. I've talked so much, you have to know everything about me by now. But let's go to the group.
Yeah, do questions? C'est question?
C'est cochon.
It's pig.
Oh, I know.
Avez-vous des questions?
You have no questions. No?
Where are you? Who gave me this? She's probably not here. She's waiting in line for that, in that bob line. Oh, I saw that and I was coming. I was like, no way.
It's a Bob Heeman.
Bob Line. Bob Heeman.
Proceed, monsieur. Is that a question line, or is that just a group of people?
No. But remember one thing, that you were supposed to be my the co-host
with me. Yes.
And I feel like really good about being there, you know, in the fans' side.
Yeah.
And having you entertain me, because it's been one day and a half that I'm screaming, shouting, making weird things.
Cochon noises.
When I said we're making weird things with them, I mean, like running in the corridors and...
I mean, I don't know about you, but we did a whole song of Frozen yesterday. I still have to put it together so I can post it. It was pretty sensational. I'm pretty proud of everybody. Yeah. Honestly, we're gonna do it again and have just Chris sing the whole thing.
No.
Chris is gonna do the whole Frozen song. Just let it go, Chris. Let it go. You can't hold it back anymore. Just let it go. Let it go. Let the storm do what it's gonna do.
Chris, how's your Instagram doing?
Un moment, s'il vous plaît. Daniel.
Don't speak French, it's gonna get you out of this.
Where are these people?
That's a good question. I was also confused.
It's just people that suck at English. So I took them with me. Just like that. You can just talk in English. No. And it's just like when you say important stuff. I can translate to them.
This is how it started. It started like this.
And he still wasn't listening. I didn't even remember how the song started.
The La Famille song. I was sitting there, I'm like, that's a cool noise. I'm not gonna do it again, but that's how it started.
Bon, par contre, je me souviens qu'ils avaient kiffé un truc, c'était la chanson La Nuit en Rose. Est-ce que vous êtes chaud pour tous la chanter? Alors. On va faire un petit décompte. This one is for you because I know you guys, you loved it. So, since we have La Famille, one thing that is important is to give something to you that it will remind you something. 3, 2, 1, go!
We love you guys so much. No, I love you more. No. I love you more.
No.
Agree to disagree. Does anybody have questions at all? Hello.
Hi. Si votre personnage devrait mourir.
It's so frustrating to hear the beginning of something and people going, oh, and having no idea what it means. She could have called me a cochon for all I know.
If your characters had to die, how do you picture your death? Would it be like in a huge fight or death by aging? Or
maybe you'll see it this season.
No!
Maybe you won't. Maybe you will. Jackson could slip and fall. He could. he could buy the wrong candy bar and eat it, and it could be poisson, poison, not fish.
vous le saurez peut-être sur la saison 5, hein, on sait jamais, peut-être qu'il meurt pas, peut-être qu'il va glisser et tomber, peut-être qu'il va manger une barre chocolatée qu'il n'aurait pas dû, peut-être du poison.
If Jackson were to die, hypothetically, I would like it if there was like, if there was a big battle and there was like fire all over the place and Abby and Miller were stuck in the middle of a large battle. Jackson came in and he had to push three guys away, carry Miller and Abby out, drop them on the ground, and hold off 50 guys in the last heroic effort, and get stabbed 17 times and still be fighting, and then in his last breath fall to the ground.
I've been crawling up inside your lungs, feeling up your mind with my tongue. I didn't need to know, but now I need to run. Tonight we roll, we rock. She thinks that Miller is getting darker and darker in the season 4. Do you think that Miller did it because it was just a question of survival, or it was just for the whole group, his whole clan?
I think he's a very loyal dude, so if I try to play it as if, unfortunately, murder is not a big issue. If it's been decided that the friendship or the relationship is no longer what it was, I think he's very good at compartmentalizing what they were, separating the past from where they're at. Do you know what I mean? I don't think that he's. I think he'll do whatever he wants. I think cold. I'm trying to play him as very cold, but a good guy. Yeah, whatever it takes, I guess. Yeah.
Il dit, Miller, il devient de plus en plus froid, en fait, et il a le côté où il arrive vraiment à séparer et à compartimenter les choses. C'est ça reste un soldat entraîné, donc du coup il est sur le... Même s'il y a une amitié, etc., les choses n'étant plus qu'elles étaient, s'il y a des choses qui changent dans les relations entre eux, il n'a pas de problème à prendre les décisions qui s'imposent. Mais du coup c'est juste de la séparation dans ce qu'il y a à faire, c'est comme ça, point barre, côté militaire.
Thank you.
Hi.
Hi.
Ma question c'est si vous pouviez jouer un autre personnage, ce serait lequel? Voilà.
Dans la série. If you had the chance to play another character in the show, which one would you pick?
I always say Bellamy because he does the most. He does the most. Does. He talks on the show. He gets to say some shit.
Il dit si je dis toujours Bellamy, puisque clairement c'est lui qui fait la série.
That's not sad. That's
not sad. So I love the fact that Luna was a Nightblood. But unfortunately I didn't get to do all the stunts and like be as much of a badass, so I think I would say either Alexa or Indra. I think Indra is like the powerhouse of female on the show. Yeah.
Elle dit même si j'ai beaucoup aimé être Luna et d'être une Nightblood, elle dit j'ai quand même pas fait beaucoup de mes cascades, etc. Elle dit si je devais choisir, je dirais Alexa ou Indra. Elle dit pour moi Indra elle représente vraiment le pouvoir de la femme forte et badass.
Alors ma question c'est si vous pouvez faire revivre un des personnages de la série, qui ce serait et pourquoi?
If you had a chance to resurrect one character of the show, which one would it be and why?
To what?
Resurrect, like back to life.
Wells. Or Alexa.
Probably Alexa, because I'd like to see some more sexy time between her and Alexa. Yeah. See sexy time between Clark and Alexa. It's pretty hot.
Alexa, parce que j'aimerais bien voir une scène plus sexy entre Alexa et Clark. C'est le groupe C, s'il vous plaît, pour les duos. Chris Chelsea.
I decided that Wells and Miller were
fine. Et le D pour Chris et Chelsea. Groupe C et groupe D pour les duos Chelsea, Chris. Group C and group D for the shoot duo. Chris et Chelsea, please. Et le groupe E pour Chris et Chelsea. Group E as well for Chris et Chelsea.
I decided that Miller and Wells were friends. They were friends.
Il dit, moi je sais que Miller et Wells ils sont amis. Là haut.
Playing basket.
Would you have liked to have another strong friendship with someone else in the show as a character?
Bellamy and Miller have a history. They were good friends. That's why I was brought onto the show, was to be Bellamy's best friend, kind of his right-hand man. It would be nice to see more of why they're friends.
Entre Bellamy et donc Miller, il dit parce qu'à la base, la raison pour laquelle Miller a été amené dans la série, parce que c'était le meilleur ami de Bellamy, et il aimerait bien qu'on en voit un peu plus sur la raison, en fait, du lien qui est entre eux.
Because I love Indra so much, probably Indra. And I mean, Luna wouldn't really want to be friends with anyone, or even.
Indra au départ parce que vraiment elle adore Indra. Elle dit après Luna, je la vois pas trop en côté amitié et ça, etc. Elle dit mais probablement Raven.
Hello, j'aimerais savoir quels sont leurs points communs avec leur personnage et ce qu'ils aiment chez leur personnage ou ce qu'ils n'aiment pas.
What are the traits that you share with your characters? And what do you like about your characters and what you dislike?
I'm pretty forgiving. I mean, we all fuck up sometimes. We're humans. So Luna is that, I'm Nadia is that. And I also think once Luna is done, she's done. And I'm pretty much the same way. Once you betrayed me or I walk away and I never look back. I am, and Luna is forgiving, but it depends on what you do. Like, you know, making mistakes is human, and we all do them. But there are like certain things you do them to me or Luna, and you're just not part of our lives anymore.
À la base, un truc qu'elle partage avec Luna, c'est le côté de pardonner. Elle dit bon, après, ça dépend dans quelle mesure, mais voilà, on est tous humains, on fait tous des erreurs. Elle dit par contre, un autre truc qu'on partage avec Luna, c'est qu'une fois que quelque chose est terminé, c'est terminé.
You know what? It's a good way of saying like I love you, but I love myself more. That's pretty much me.
Un truc qu'elle partage avec Luna, c'est je t'aime, mais je t'aime plus.
I'm gonna get this out of the way. This was only the second time. The second time I ever left Canada, so it's a big deal for me. So the fact that we've done it three times kind of blows my mind because I never once traveled growing up. So I feel like this time was amazing to talk to you guys and remember your names and just feel like we were hanging out as opposed to a business. The business operation. This wasn't business. It was awesome. I love you guys. Thank you for making me feel at home. I feel French. I feel very French. This is my favorite non-Canadian city in the world, and I hope to keep coming. And one big reason for it, aside from you guys, is Donya. Since you've made me feel so Parisian, I want to christen you with some Canadiana, and you are an honorary Torontonian.
Until
you go on your own. So, her brother and her have shown me the whole friggin' town, where to eat, where to go, do things, and I feel like we're family, and I hope we stay friends for the rest of our lives. Her brother won't come on stage. He's around somewhere, and I love him too. So, thank you for your love.
Thank you.
quand même sa, c'est sa vie non canadienne clairement préférée. La manière dont vous le faites ressentir, c'est quand même, à la base, c'était la troisième fois qu'il sortait du Canada. Et juste vraiment, merci à vous et bon, beaucoup d'amour pour Donia, énormément d'amour pour vous.
Been the best time of our lives. And I think the greatest thing about it is that we saw you all 3 years ago. At that time, a lot of you guys were just babies. And honestly, it's insane to watch you guys grow up. And I think a lot of it is because everybody here is so amazing that in 3 years, the amount that we've grown, you've all grown into such beautiful, light-filled, loving individuals. There is nobody here that has about BS, ego, nothing. You guys are all just sensational individuals, and it's such an honor for us to see people that we call family now grow into that, because it's super sweet that this many people are that good and bring that much good into the world. So we love you. Thank you so much.
Merci aux acteurs, bien sûr, d'être là, comme toujours au rendez-vous. Merci au meilleur staff du monde, un tonnerre d'applaudissements. C'est pas tout le staff, mais je vous jure qu'à la fin, enfin le dimanche soir, ils ont l'impression d'avoir travaillé un an. Laura qui vous fait tout le graphisme.
Ouais. Thank you very much to Ultimate Events staff, because as you said, the staff members are the best of the world. You have no idea, you see them on the weekend, but it's 1 year of working about the convention, and after Sunday night, it feels like the whole weekend lasted for 1 year, so they're exhausted. And also thank you to Laura, who did all the graphics of all the badges, the pass, the autograph, the tickets, everything.
Merci encore une fois à tout le staff présent ce weekend. Merci au chef d'équipe Nadine, Solène, merci à Thomas d'avoir couru partout. Le staff est génial, eux, ils gèrent le staff, donc peut-être qu'ils sont 0,0001% de plus, je sais pas. Merci bon, aux assistants, à Daniel, merci aux acteurs, merci à la sécurité, merci à Simone, à la caisse. Faites du bruit, elle est encore à la caisse. S'occuper des acteurs comme elle le fait. Merci aux agents. Je sais que j'ai oublié des membres du staff. Je suis désolée, mais vraiment, je vous aime tous. Les photographes, Jean qui imprime, tout le monde. Je suis désolée. Voilà. Et merci à vous.
She was thanking everyone, so I'm not gonna give all the names now, but thank you to you guys for coming again and being with us. And the most important thing, it's if this is happening, it's because of you, so thanks to you.
Another spacewalk!
for the part two, it's time.
I need your full and undivided attention.
No, please.
Did
you get very far?
Yeah.
I just start shouting loud on me.
That's at the end.
Right.
I don't know if you guys know, but my birthday is on Tuesday.
Yeah.
I just wanted to thank all you guys, La Famille, for all the wonderful things you've said to me and made me feel incredibly special. And I think about where I was last year seeing you guys and how much you filled my heart. And now this year, getting to spend, you know, another very important day for me in my life, but with all you guys, I'm just very grateful. And that's what we're talking about, which is gratitude. And I think I can speak for all of us that we are so fucking grateful that we can come to Paris and hug you guys. And you give us candy. And we're gonna love you and you love us.
I didn't need to know, but now I need to understand.